Here with Billy Mogford again, and we're going to be talking about a film, Perfect Tense, about a young gymnast. And it's quite an intriguing film, isn't it? You're going to tell us a bit more about it, because it's got an interesting twist in it, is that
right? Yeah, I mean, it's very nice. It's a very cute film, but then it gets very dark in some parts.
Yeah.
It kind of shows the life of children growing up in certain areas.
London?
London, Brighton, anywhere really. It's not anywhere in particular, and it's not a particular story. It's different stories of it's just a made-up story basically, but it shows how some children can grow up in life and the dark sides of life.
Like an inner city. It's kind of an inner city.
It's kind of inner city, and then there's some scenes where it's countryside and stuff, and then it's all over really. It just shows how some young children can grow up.
Yeah, in difficult circumstances.
In difficult circumstances, yeah.
Yeah. Where's the young gymnast coming to this?
There's two of the main characters. The young gymnast, she's called Lee. She's called Frankie in real life. She was a first-time actor, really, really good actress. And then there was the other part that was played, the other main character, which was Joe.
Yeah.
His name is Alfie, he's another first-time actor. The two of them are family members. They're half-brother and sister.
Yeah.
The girl lives with her dad, and then the boy comes to live with them. They're at loggerheads. They kind of have a family feud because they don't really want to be brother and sister, but they're stuck with each other, so to speak. The dad's a bit of a waste of space. He's a man from Waterloo Road. He's a real actor. And the part that I play is a villain called Reese. So Joe is broke, he's got no money, and he wants to make some money for himself, and he gets involved with the darker people of the area.
Yeah.
And I'm a gang leader.
Okay.
He gets involved with me, and it gives a bit of a diversity to the film, makes it a bit dark.
Yeah, because I know you do mixed martial arts as well, so you want to be an actor in the future, is that...?
Well, this wasn't something that I tried to do. It was a walk-in audition.
Right.
And the director was blown away by me a little bit.
Yeah.
She said I'd fit the role perfectly.
And is it a big part? I know it's not been released yet, has it?
No, it's not been released.
Is it a leading part in the film?
Yeah, definitely.
Right.
Yeah.
Is it feature-length?
Yeah, feature-length film.
Right.
It was produced by the BBC.
Yeah.
It was funded by the BBC, should I say.
So it's BBC production?
Yeah. It was premiered a month ago in Leicester Square. Big festival bought it. I can't think of the name. In Leicester Square.
That's fine. But it's called Perfect Ten anyway. To be honest, it sounds quite a big deal, particularly if it's BBC, because we know they've got a lot of money. So.
Good production. Definitely.
Yeah.
Can't think of the production that bought it.
So we'll look out for that, though.
London
Film Festival. Okay, there you go. So we'll be looking out for that in the future now. What other plans have you got then for the future? Acting wise,
well, that remains to be seen.
Are you kind of actively looking for roles?
Well, as of present, no.
Okay, but I know that you're doing.
I want to see where it goes with this.
You're doing mixed martial arts as well.
Yeah.
So I know we mentioned that previously in a previous interview. With the victory fights.
Yeah.
So I guess you've got that going on as well.
Yeah, that's my dream.
Hopefully you can come back when a film's going to be released.
Yeah, definitely.
We don't know it yet. We'll see if we can show some clips as well.
And I'll try and come back when I'm a professional MMA fighter.
Bye.
In the UFC.
Thanks for coming in, Billy.
No worries. Cheers.
Thanks.